It's time for an update on the OPR Vessel. We launched it back in November thinking that we were ready to clean plastic from the ocean, but we quickly learned during our test that we had to go back to the shipyard and make some more modifications in order to deploy these systems efficiently and effectively. So come with us and take a look at all the changes we've made. All right, this is the boom system that we used to have installed on the stern of the vessel.
The boom system is self-inflating, and it basically gets anchored to one point, wraps around, and the current from the river mouth will open it up. It'll get anchored to another point, and it basically blocks off the mouth of the river from all the debris and plastic floating out.
Originally, there was a huge jump deck platform, and you can see the footprint from where the old reel used to be. So we had to walk up a flight of stairs and then to a jump platform on the stern. What we've done is come to an open stern concept. And basically what we've done is cut the bulwarks down and angled them down and made it to where now retrieval and deployment of boom material is much easier.
So when we load up, we can have this vessel anchored outside the river. The small boats be going and servicing the booms, bringing the plastic back, we load it up onto the boat, bring it to the case, store it, right. Load the vessels, and we're gone.
Cool.
So another important piece of equipment that we had to install on this vessel in order to deploy our boom systems is the capstan winch. This is a winch that's capable of pulling 35,000 pounds at a time. Now as you look at this deck, it's 24 feet wide by 70 feet long. Each one of our boom systems is 20-foot sections that weigh 420 pounds. Some rivers might require 5, other rivers might require 50. So as you can imagine, it would be very difficult to move these heavy objects around by ourselves. We used to have a ladder here. We actually had to install a stair system in case of an emergency. Our crew can reach the second level and get to our fast rescue boat.
So the OPR vessel previously did not have this rescue boat installed. So
we had to install this platform down here that the rescue boat sits on.
We had to install these brackets that she sits on. And then we also had to install this davit that deploys a rescue boat in an emergency situation.
Check everything, check your spotlight, check everything out, make sure everything's good, your fuel's pumped up.
All new electronics on the boats, VHF radios, 2 updated radars. We've got GPS systems. We have an autopilot. We have AIS. We have a NavTech system. Mm-hmm. And then, of course, we've got our full plotting capability to go international. We are certainly getting close. There's a lot of details that have to be tightened up. And there's so much involved, so many things to pull together, so many details.
One thing that we would really like to clear the air about is the claim that this vessel alone was going to remove 90% of the plastic from the world's oceans. As you can see, it's a physical impossibility for that to happen. The quote that we were referencing was, it is estimated that up to 90% of plastic that is entering the ocean is entering through river mouths. We just hoped with our vessel and our boom systems, we could have an impact on that 90% that is entering into the ocean. So you guys have seen all the modifications that we've had to do to this vessel. We're stoked to say we are on the 1-yard line and we are closer to launching this vessel and cleaning plastic out of the ocean. Stay tuned, guys.
Yoo!